Good morning. Today you want to see the book of Romans, chapter 3. Romans chapter 3. From verse 21, from verse 19, from verse 19 to 25. Now we read Romans chapter 3 from verse 19 to 25. Now we know that whatever the law says, it says to those who are under the law, so that every mouth may be silenced and the whole world held accountable to God. Therefore no one will be declared righteous in his sight by observing the law. Rather, through the law, we become conscious of sin. But now a righteousness from God apart from the law being made known, to which the law and the prophets testify, the righteousness from God comes through faith in Jesus Christ to all who believe. There is no difference, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God and are justified freely by His grace through the redemption that came by Christ Jesus. God presented Him as a sacrifice of atonement through faith in His blood. He did this to demonstrate His justice, because in His forbearance He had left the sins committed beforehand unpunished. Amen. So today we want to see this Apostle Paul's teaching about the law and the gospel. What is the core? What is the summary? The summary is this: through the law, we can know that we are the sinners. But then, by the law, we cannot be saved. But then, by believing in Jesus, that Jesus died for our sins, then we can be saved. In other words, by observing the law, we cannot be saved, but by the love of God, by the forgiveness of God, we can be saved. You can say this way. But then, we also need to know another one is, Jesus did not try to destroy the law. Your righteousness needs to be better than the righteousness of the Pharisees. We need to keep the law well. But then the law cannot save us. We need to know this clearly. We should not despise the law. We need to keep the law well. But then, another thing we need to know is that the law cannot save us. It can be by the law. Through the law, we become conscious of sin. And we can realize that we are the sinners. The law can teach us like that. In other parts in the Bible, Apostle Paul was teaching that then the law is like the teachers when we are young. It can teach us. It can guide us up to some point. That is the law. It can be a teacher. For example, we need to have the basic things as a Christians. Basic things. Do you want to be a good fighter? Then you need to be trained from the basic things. The law can teach us the basic things. We should not despise the law. We need to know the law well. We need to be very legalistic. Our righteousness should be better than the righteousness of the Pharisees. But the law can't save us, but the grace of God by the sacrifice of Jesus Christ on the cross, we could be saved. We cannot save the people with the law itself, but we can save the people with love, with sacrifice, with the love of God. We can save, we can guide the people to salvation. So, we need to realize this. There are so many people are dying in the world, even now. So many people are dying or are killing themselves. So we need to go to them quickly, and we need to teach them well. We need to guide them to salvation. That's our duty. But then the law, only by the law we cannot save them, but by love, by the love of God, we can save the people in the world. The same among the members, among the leaderships. We need to embrace the sins of the members and leaders. We need to also pray for them. And then we can save each other. From verse 19, now we know that whatever the law says, it says to those who are under the law, so that every mouth may be silenced and the whole world held accountable to God. Yeah, we cannot say anything before God. From verse 9, we can read from verse 9. What shall we conclude then? Are we any better? Not at all. We have already made the charge that Jews and Gentiles alike are all under sin. As it is written, there is no one righteous, not even one. There is no one who understands, no one who asks God. All have turned away, they have together become worthless. There is no one who does good, not even one. This is God's declaration for this world. There is no one who is righteous before God, who can boast of themselves. At John chapter 8 then, no one could start to stone the woman who was caught in the middle of adultery. All disappeared. What does it mean? Nobody could be righteous before God. Nobody could be, no one could be sinless. All the people in the world, we are the sinners. The sinner cannot judge another sinner. But then this is the final judgment. We can use the law. When we look at somebody is not doing well, then we cannot just be quiet. We need to teach them. This is wrong. Isn't it? That is common sense. So then he can be changing. He can know, that's wrong. The same when you are teaching the children, we need to teach them well with the law. Isn't it? That is common sense. But then, fundamentally, we cannot really judge others. It's true. But then we can teach them, we can guide them. We can say, you are wrong. Say yes to yes, no to no. We need to say this one. Isn't it? And then that society can develop, that organization can develop, grow. But then not for judgment, for judgment. For the development, with the love, we can say the word of judgment. Truth. We are all the sinners, but then we cannot really judge others as I am a judge. I cannot be a judge. But as a sinners, as we are living together, working together for the kingdom of God, as a gathering of the sinners, still we can discuss. We can discuss for the development of the church. From that viewpoint, we can discuss. We can also say, wrong is wrong, right is right. So then we can develop. We can remove the sins, the bad things away. Then we can develop the good things. But we need to know there is no one righteous before God. Verse 13. Their throats are open grave, their tongues practice deceit, the poison of vipers on their lips, their mouths are full of cursing and bitterness. It's almost talking about the sins through the mouth, the sins by words. Verse 14. Their mouths are full of cursing and bitterness. Their feet are swift to shed blood. Yeah, many people are quick to commit sin, going here and there. Very realistic. I myself was there. Very quick to go to commit sin. Even at night, they are going here and there. To commit more sins. Their feet are swift to shed blood. Ruin and misery mark their ways, and the way of peace they do not know. Yeah, they are not peaceful. In their heart, the true peace are not there. Pleasure. The pleasure through the sins are there, but then regretting, always they are regretting. They are not peaceful. They are not stable. They cannot be stable. They cannot have the peace in their heart. There is no fear of God before their eyes. Yeah. The evil people. They commit sin because they don't have fear toward God. That's why they commit sin. They don't fear about the judgment. That's why we need to teach them how fearful is God, how fearful the God's judgment for their sinful life. Sometimes we need to teach them. Peter did this one. Acts chapter 2. You killed Jesus. Peter said, you are a great sinner. You killed Jesus. Ah, really? What should we do? So people were asking Peter, what should we do? We need to teach them that they are the sinners first. And then they can realize they can be longing for their salvation. We need to teach this law first. That's why our pastor is always emphasizing about the book of Romans. We need to teach them about the salvation. We need to teach them from the sins. We don't need to teach them from the creation. We don't have enough time. Does it make sense? Yeah, it makes sense. We need to teach them. We need the salvation. As we are the sinners, we need to help them to realize how we are the great sinners. And then we need the salvation from God. We don't have enough time to start from the creation. You know, so that's not the point. That's not the point. We have four spiritual law. What is it? Creation, sin, and salvation, and the kingdom of God. And if we remove one among them, what should we remove? What can we remove? Creation or the kingdom of God. Maybe creation. And then if we remove one more, what can we remove? What can we remove? The other one, among the two, creation or kingdom of God. And then if we remove one more sin, the last one, what can be remaining? And salvation, I think so. So that's why we are really focusing on, we are really guiding the leaders to teach the people with the book of Romans. That is the core of the gospel. The core in the Bible, the Bible's teaching. Salvation. Sin and salvation. We are the sinners, we need to teach them. What is the problem of the people in the world? That's the problem. They don't realize they are the sinners, isn't it? That's the problem. They don't realize how they are sinners. Ah, I'm good. I was taking care of my family well. I'm a teacher. They cannot realize that is a big issue. That's why we need to teach them with the word, with the law. Then we need to help them to realize that they are also big sinners before God. When they realize that they are the sinners, then they can ask us, what should we do for our salvation? They can ask us, what should we do? There is no fear of God before their eyes. That is the starting of their sins, simple life. We are all the sinners. But now, we know that, verse 19, we know that whatever the law says, it says to those who are under the law, so that every mouth may be silenced and the whole world held accountable to God. Yeah, we cannot say anything as a sinner. We, as we are realize, we are the sinners. We cannot excuse ourselves. It's just an excuse. But we cannot escape from this fact that we are the sinners. Verse 20, therefore, no one will be declared righteous in his sight by observing the law. Rather, through the law, we become conscious of sin. Yeah, through the law, we become conscious of sin. That's why we need the law. Through the law, by the law, it can help us to realize that we are the sinners. Ah, I didn't keep this. I'm a sinner. Huh? I'm a great sinner. But another law came out, verse 21. But now a righteousness from God apart from the law has been made known, to which the law and prophets testify. Yeah, another law, which was testified by the law, Moses' law, and the prophets, Old Testament. Verse 22, this righteousness from God comes through faith in Jesus Christ to all who believe. There is no difference, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God and are justified freely by His grace through the redemption that came by Christ Jesus. Yeah. We are justified freely by His grace. Another, by His love, by His forgiveness, we could be saved. Through what? Through this atoning sacrifice, redemption. Redeeming sacrifice for our life. By this love of God, by this sacrifice of God, we could be saved. Verse 25, God presented Him as a sacrifice of atonement through faith in His blood. So God presented Jesus as the sacrifice of atonement for this world. And then whoever believes in this, they will be saved. Whoever cries out to God, cry out the name of Jesus Christ as their Savior. Whoever come before God, repenting their sins, believing that Jesus Christ died for their sins, they will be, whoever believes in this, they will be saved. This is grace of God, love of God, forgiveness of God for our life. So we need to realize this deeply. And then we also need to teach them this deeply. But then, firstly, we need to teach them they are also the great sinners. We are the great sinners. And then, they can realize that this grace of God is so important. But the usually here, what's the problem? They don't maybe know about their sinfulness, their sins. But then they just talk about, God loves me, God loves me. It's also very tricky, stuffy, isn't it? God loves me. God's grace is great. Why is it great? Why is the God's grace great? What kind of grace of God is it? Just God loves you? For what? Just what God wants to feed you? Huh? It's not you, right? Yeah. Because even though we are the great sinners, you are shedding the blood, you are so selfish. Our hearts are so dark and dirty, ugly. But God forgave all our sins as we believe that Jesus died for my sins. Then God forgave all my sins. And then even God won't accept me in heaven. God cleansed all my sins away from me with the power of the blood of Jesus Christ. That's why we can give thanks to God. Firstly, they need to know this first. And then they will come before God. They will shout. They will cry out to God. They will come before the cross. The Savior. For the forgiveness of their sins, with the power of the blood of Jesus Christ on the cross. So, as we look at this, we want to meditate this deeply today. Yeah, we are the sinners. We, by the law, by observing the law, we cannot be saved. But by the law, we can realize we are the great sinners. But then, by believing, by faith, by the grace of God, we could be saved. By the sacrifice of Jesus Christ, as an atoning sacrifice on the cross, then we could be saved. So the law can kill us, but then the gospel can save us. The grace of God can save us. That word is very true. When we deal with the people, with the law itself, yeah, we can kill the people. But then if we teach them with the love, then we can save them. But then, not just with the love, I love you. Yeah? Whatever they do, we can, if we say that, then, you are okay, you are forgiven, it cannot really teach them well. So that's why we need to teach them well. You did this wrong. This is wrong. This is wrong. So I will remove you from this ministry. Then at the time, they can realize how they were sinner. And then when they realize, and they really repent, then maybe at the time, maybe they realize that, this is also the grace of God. The reason how I can be here. By the grace of God, I can be there. And then we can teach them the gospel also. Not just the resurrection only. Not just with the cross only. We need to teach them both of them well. Cross and resurrection. The law and the gospel. And then people can realize, understand the gospel and the law well, then as people can really live according to the will of God, even keeping the law well, then they can grow. They can grow as a leader. They cannot really grow as a leader only by the love and those. Love is essential. But then we also need, they need to also be kept with the law. So then they can also put the order. They can make the organization, ministries. They can operate the ministries well. As they have the law. standard, or rules. But then, by the rules, by the standard, or by the law, it cannot save us. By the love of God, by the forgiveness of God, by love, we can be comforted. We can have the peace. We can be saved. We can be encouraged. Even the person who are trying to commit suicide, they can be, they don't commit suicide. Love. Love can save the people. So as we meditate this word of God, we want to live realizing that then how God saved us with His love, great love, sacrifice on the cross. And then as we live, knowing it, realizing it deeply, and then as we live, knowing the law also well, and as we are practicing the law, and then, but then as we live with faith, that the love could save us, the love of God, sacrifice of God could save us. So then we also want to work for the kingdom of God, knowing this with the law, but then the love can save the people. The law can guide the people. Yeah, we can, with the law, we can guide the people. We can operate the ministries, rules. But then the love can save the people. The love can save the people, encourage the people, save their life. So as we know this clearly, so then we want to live meditating this love of God, great love of God for our life. And then we also want to work for the kingdom of God, knowing this and applying this well, so then our life can be fruitful in God. So we want to end here. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for allowing us this time to meditate your word. As Jesus died on the cross, then he could save the sinners in this world. So many people are dying in their sins, in discouragement, or in despair. Without love, true love, many people are dying in their sins. But then, as we are saved by your love, then we also want to deliver this good news to many people in this world. And then, but as we are also teaching them with the law, guide them, and then we also need to, we also want, as we also teach them with the love of God, forgiveness of God, so then we really want to guide many people to live according to your will, and then to be saved by your great love, so then many people can be saved through our life of faith. So please be with us, guide each one of us today, then help us, provide for us, so then each member in our church can really experience you deeply, and then they can grow in you, and then they can really live giving thanks to God, glorifying your name. So thank you for all your grace through this time. Then I pray all this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you all.